मेरा नाम है साई चरण, मैं आंध्र प्रदेश से आता हूँ। आई बिलोंग टू विजयवाड़ा। मेरा पढ़ाई IIT खड़गपुर से किया हूँ 2021 में, और बाद में आई ज्वाइन HAL हिंदुस्तान एरोनॉटिक्स लिमिटेड बेंगलुरु में काम किया है 1.5 साल। उसके बाद मैं इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज 2022 के दौरान AAR 19 आ चुका है, एंड आफ्टर देन आई ज्वाइन सेंट्रल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी अथॉरिटी द CPES कैडर इन न्यू दिल्ली, एंड दिस टाइम आई सिक्योर्ड ऑल इंडिया रैंक 1 इन द इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज 2023 ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन डोमेन। माई फादर इज अ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग प्रोफेसर एट NRI इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी विजयवाड़ा। मदर इज अ हाउस मेकर। मेरा एक छोटा भाई है, वो IIT मद्रास में पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं MTech। मैं पहली बार 2021 में ESC दे दिया है, बट आई कुड नॉट क्लियर द फाइनल लिस्ट। मैं इंटरव्यू तक गया हूँ, 584 मार्क्स आई सिक्योर्ड, एंड देन इन इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज 2022 में मेरे को 661 मार्क्स आई। आफ्टर देन इन इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज 2023 आई सिक्योर्ड ऑल इंडिया रैंक 1। लेट मी स्टार्ट माई प्रिपरेशन स्ट्रैटेजी फॉर इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज प्रीलिम्स। इट कंटेन्स टू पेपर्स, वन इज जनरल स्टडीज एंड द अदर इज डोमेन स्पेसिफिक पेपर, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग। And then for general studies contains 200 marks, whereas the domain specific paper has 300 marks weightage. So for general studies, I chose specific subjects that I wanted to prepare for, suppose engineering aptitude and mathematics, and material science, information communication technologies, and project management. There are other remaining subjects which I was not comfortable in. So I just had basic fundamentals regarding those subjects which I used to answer the basic questions. And then coming to the domain specific paper of prelims, we have to observe that this is a objective paper. Whenever I was in doubt, I used my elimination techniques to answer the questions, and time management is also very important. So for this purpose, I made use of test series, online test series as well as offline test series from different institutes, which helped me for effective utilization of time. Coming to my resources, so I made use of the online content that is available on YouTube to work on my weaker areas, such as communication systems, analog electronics, which I was having difficulty. So I made notes, proper notes out of them, and used the same notes for my revision. Coming to mains, it again has two papers which are both technical, 300 marks each for 3 hours. And the main difference is from prelims to mains is that prelims is objective, whereas mains is conventional. So it is a subjective question paper which comes along with the question come answer booklet format. And in this, so the most important thing is to choose the proper questions, choose the right questions to attempt. We have to choose 5 out of the 8 questions given, and this is the most essential part. For mains and prelims both, I made use of the previous equations last 10 to 15 years. So these are very essential. Just before the examination also, I made use of the previous equations, the attempted the online test series, given mock tests, which helped me give the actual environment of the examination. Moving on to interview. Interview consists of 200 marks, and this time my panel chairperson was Raj Shukla sir. And then the very first question he asked was, why am I reappearing for the engineering services examination? And this is a very common question that any repeater has to be aware of. So, and later on, they asked me more trickier HR based questions and situation based questions, like how would I deal with employees or workers that are going on strike, etc. There was also a question on my hobbies, like naming a few Indian cricket and chess players, also the major event that is going on in the cricket, etc. And the technical questions were a little bit on an easier side, like the Nyquist sampling rate was asked, and also they asked me about my BTech project. And my BTech project was based on ML, so they asked me questions related to machine learning, artificial intelligence, and also ChatGPT. I would like to tell some few tips, do's and don'ts also regarding the engineering services. The first thing is, everyone has their own strategy. Make your own strategy which suits yourself. You are the best person that knows about you. And one more thing is, identify your strengths and weaknesses. Everyone has their favorites. Everyone struggles with some of the subjects. But what I suggest is, hone your strengths and work on your weaker areas. Also, attempt the test series in such a way that you are utilizing the proper time. You are able to attempt the questions properly. Also, accept the fact that you need not score 100% in this examination. It is observed that even 50% score is sufficient enough to make it into the final list. Avoid making silly mistakes. Be confident during the examination. Regarding the examination, during the examination, I would like to suggest a few tips that could be useful for any of the future aspirants. Especially in prelims, it is an objective paper. So, time management is essential, as well as accuracy. So, speed and accuracy are both the essential factors in prelims. And general studies contains only 200 marks. So, less weightage can be given to general studies when compared to the technical paper. Answer the easier questions first, and later on you can move on to the doable as moderate and difficult questions. Engineering services requires lot of patience and perseverance to clear this examination. This is a whole lot journey of 1.5 years from the date of filling your application to the date of the result. So it drains lot of energy from aspirant's end, and everyone must keep themselves motivated, internally motivated, etc. during the whole phase of the journey. Also, pursue your hobbies along with the exam preparation. This helps you keep active during the whole phase of the preparation. Also, do not neglect your health, that is physical, mental, as well as your emotional health. I'd like to give few tips to different category of candidates aspiring for engineering services. One is the freshers. One common question would be, like, when should I start my preparation for engineering services? And the answer for that could be as soon as possible, that is from your second year of engineering, because that's when the core subjects will start. And if you can manage your preparation parallel along with your curriculum, that would be really helpful in your preparation as well. And further repeaters, or for people who are dedicatedly preparing for engineering services after graduation, I like to say that practice makes a man perfect. And I really hope that just keep yourselves motivated and do not deviate from your goals. I'd like to conclude this with two of my famous sayings that I used to have in my room always. One is of a quote by Swami Vivekananda: arise, awake, and stop not until the goal is reached. I used to be motivated by Swami Vivekananda's quotes, and this early every morning, this used to give me an inspiration for the day. One more quote by Nelson Mandela: the greatest glory in life lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall. So this teaches that everyone has their own setbacks in their life, and only those who can rise from those setbacks will achieve their dreams. Thank you.